Welcome back, students. We were seeing the topic molecular basis of inheritance. So now let's see the double helix structure of DNA. In most structural configuration, adenine and thymine form two hydrogen bonds. That means between adenine and thymine there is two hydrogen bonds, whereas in guanine and cytosine there are three hydrogen bonds. Now the two strands of DNA are complementary. That means they are not identical to each other. It is this property that makes DNA uniquely suited to store and transmit the genetic information. As you can see in this picture, that the strands of the DNA have helices, right? They are coiled also. So these, if suppose here is adenine, here will be thymine joined with two hydrogen bonds, and if here is guanine, here will be cytosine joined with three hydrogen bonds. Okay, so now here if one strand is having this, it will be complemented, the next strand will be complementary. Okay, so this makes DNA a unique molecule, or you can say unique gene, which carries a specific protein function or protein function synthesis. The base pairs in the DNA are stacked about 34 angstrom. Apart with this, there are 10 base pairs per turn. That means here, as per 360 degree turn, there are 10 base pairs. Okay, here there are about 10 base pairs. The sugar phosphate backbones of the two complementary strands are anti-parallel, and that is why they have the opposite chemical property. As I have told you in last session, that 5' end is complementary with the 3' end. And as 5' ends with the 3', it will be complementary to the 5'. Okay. Now, as one move unidirectionally along the DNA double helix, the phosphodiester bonds in one strand go from 3 carbon of one nucleotide to the 5 carbon of the adjacent nucleotide. Whereas those in complementary strand go from 5 carbon to 3 carbon. Okay, if we'll go regarding the phosphodiester bond, that means if it is starting from the phosphate group, it will be from 3' end to 5'. But if we'll go regarding the complementary strand, then it would be from 5' end to 3'. Okay, this opposite polarity of the complementary strand is very important in considering the mechanism of replication of DNA. That means if it is starting from 3', then the replication would be, the replicate of that DNA would be starting from 5'. Okay. Now the high degree of stability of DNA double helices results in the part of the large number of hydrogen bonds between these pairs. That means whatever hydrogen bonding is there, or you can say, depending upon the large number of hydrogen bonds present between the pairs, more is the stability in the DNA. Now although each hydrogen bond by itself quite weak, since number of hydrogen bonds are more, it can withstand. Now the planar side of the base pairs are relatively non-polar and thus tend to be water insoluble. That means they are hydrophobic. This hydrophobic core stacked the base pairs contributes considerable stability of DNA molecules present in the aqueous protoplasm of living cells. That means in the bacteria, as you know, the DNA is freely moving, or you can say it's free in the cytoplasm or protoplasm. As they are water insoluble, they provide a stability. So students, in this session we have seen the DNA double helices structure. In further session we will have a more detailed look regarding the molecular basis of inheritance. Thank you.